Every May, pre-veterinary students have the opportunity to travel abroad to the Limpopo province of South Africa. Through this experience, students gain 250 hours of veterinary experience working with wild game veterinarians to assist game breeders with breeding and conservation of endangered species.
So the journey to South Africa was pretty cool. We actually got on a plane and headed to London first, and we had a stop over there for just a few hours, but even during that time we were able to go out and experience kind of the culture and see the sights in London, which was really cool. We then headed on another flight to Johannesburg, South Africa, which was a fairly long flight overnight. And then after that we got on a very, very tiny plane, which was kind of scary but also kind of cool. It started the adventure for us, and we headed down to Oudtshoorn.
I gained valuable clinical experience such as conducting necropsies, assisting with anti-poaching efforts, learning how to track and capture wild game, and assisting with intensive breeding procedures.
One of our activities was a trip to Kruger National Park. We spent the day there and were able to observe wildlife activity, park management, and then animals in their natural environment, which was pretty unique.
One of the main ways we assisted was in helping make sure that some of the populations of the antelope were reproductively sound and the genetics were viable.
I think the biggest soft skill I earned was communication. To listen to the veterinarian when we could get out of the truck to go towards the animal. There, hands-on experience, IM injections of a dewormer, an antibiotic, and vitamins for every animal. We also got to practice ear tagging Cape buffalo, which you need a lot of strength to do that, and practicing animal placement. So for the ruminants, you have to keep them in sternal recumbency so that they can remain healthy while they're sedated.
Another amazing species we were able to work with were giraffes, so we actually assisted in translocating them to a new location in order to protect them from poaching.
Although the cases varied from day to day, one of the most memorable experiences for me was the day I got to work with rhinos, who microchipped their horns, translocated them to protect them from poaching, as well as performed a procedure called deworming.
Another unique experience that we had was working with the endangered African wild dog species. For that project, we were testing breeding populations of these wild dogs for TB or tuberculosis, which can be transferred to them from the ruminants in that area.
During one of our days, we had the opportunity to learn about the different dart guns that Dr. Boshoff uses on a daily basis. And after learning about them, we were able to go up in the helicopter to simulate the feeling of being a wildlife veterinarian darting animals from up there, like Boshoff does every day.
One of the days, we worked with a local outreach program called HALO, run by Dr. Nina Boshoff. Through this outreach program, we work with the local South African communities to provide veterinary care for the local Afrikaner dog population.
Since returning from South Africa, I've had the opportunity to work with both Dr. Trevetti and Dr. Boshoff on some ongoing research projects that are involved with captive and wild rhinos.
One way I was able to make my experience more affordable was through receiving scholarships. I received one scholarship from the Study Abroad Office here at NC State and the other from the USDA. Those two scholarships paid for a majority of my trip, just leaving me with the cost of travel.
Thank you for watching. If you're interested in learning more about VetPAC, please review our website or contact our staff via the links below. While you're here, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more VetPAC updates.